I don't think I'm allowed to say this one.
Is it one single word?
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much sums up. Remy, you first. All right. Can you say something in Spanish?
Un bocadillo con jamón y queso, por favor.
It's all right.
That's not bad, isn't it?
That's not bad. That's
it's enough to get by.
Yeah, and at least you're not saying bocadillo.
Yeah. Bocadillo. Will you do a shoey when you do your next Moto 2 win?
Yeah, honestly, I was thinking about it, and I keep forgetting, but yeah, if I get the next Moto 2 win, I'll do a shoey. Shoey for the Hueys, isn't it?
Yeah, that's it. You got to get amongst it.
Yeah. Will we ever see the return of the mullet?
No, I reckon the mullet's done. I could pull it off when you're younger because you can look kind of half silly when you're younger and that, but I'm getting old now, so I got to kind of look semi-mature.
And
especially now, you know, like he was talking about, barbershops being shut, the zero's the easy go-to. Like, I cut this before we went to Qatar, and look at it, it's still in good condition, so I'll just keep doing that. It's like every month, so. What's your favourite Australian saying?
I don't think I'm allowed to say this one.
Is it one single word?
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much sums up.
We'll go with g'day mate or something
mate,
like that.
Yeah,
that's normally my go-to.
Keep it clean. G'day mate.
G-rated.
Best thing about being an Aussie abroad?
Not a lot. Passport doesn't get you many places. Get visas for everywhere. But people always, you know, got great things to say about Australia. Either they've been there or have friends that have gone there. So I guess that's kind of cool. Which one of your dad's bikes would you like to ride the most?
Any of the 500 Rothmans bikes.
Rothmans bike?
Not the last years. I'd probably like the 87, 88, 89 bike,
89,
the Screamer.
The Screamer.
Yeah,
I want to try the Screamer. I was going to say 89 and probably be my go-to.
Yeah.
I mean, has to be.
The Screamer, because then they went to the Big Bang, I think in the 90s. Yeah.
Well, I mean, you've ridden a 500.
I rode Kenny's.
There you go.
2000.
That would have been sick.
Yeah, yeah. What surprised me the most was the turning, mate. It was just like, I've never ridden such a fast turning bike.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Like, I was having to pick it up like that because I was going
on the grass. Yeah, I guess after riding these big heavy four strokes and getting on that thing.
You've just landed back in Oz. What are the first three things you do?
What? Pre-pandemic or now? Now is 2 weeks of quarantine and it's not much fun. My go-to normally is go to the, I always got to land in Brisbane and then change terminals. So normally when I change terminals, it's normally early in the morning. So I go to, there's like a coffee club in front and get a decent Aussie breakfast and just sort of get back in the swing of things. Nice smashed avo on toast.
Oh yeah.
Can't beat it. What's the thing you miss most from Australia?
I want to say, probably the surf.
Surf?
Yeah, the surf.
I don't have that.
I'm a surfer, you know I am. I'm from the beach, northern beaches, so.
Yeah, I think the freedom's the biggest thing. Like
freedom and open space.
Open space, being away from people is kind of a nice thing. We don't have the surf where I am because we've got a reef.
Yeah,
but like you say, the ocean. I think the ocean's definitely one of the biggest things I miss is the blue ocean.
You
look like that pool right there.
It's clean and, you know. Beautiful reefs and fish.
If you could be anyone else in the world for one day, who would it be and why?
Good
question.
Yeah, I think I got a good answer to this one. I'm gonna say James Hunt.
James Hunt.
Yep.
day and issues would be alright.
Yeah, James Hunt back in the day. What's the first thing I should know about riding for Aki.io?
I think you might already know it. No, he's good. He's serious, but he's good. I'm sure you would have had the talk and these ones, he always does these ones. But I think the biggest thing you've got to know is he's got your best interest at heart, I think is the biggest thing. And sometimes we need people like him. Well, you definitely need people like him to sort of help you keep your feet on the ground and understand where you are. And
exactly.
I think you're in a good spot. Who'd win in an MX race between you and I?
Yeah, hands down. Yeah, no, I'm not not on the motocross and not much anymore.
Have you retired?
I haven't retired.
You got to get back on it. You got to get back on it.
Yeah, I've done a few days, honestly, but I'm just
taking it easy during season.
Just doing it for fun, you know. Is it true you once sweet talked your babysitter into draining the swimming pool to turn it into a skate park?
I didn't really sweet talk her. I just told her that mum and dad let me do it all the time. So I think I was like 5 years old. And yeah, mum and dad went to like Perth or something for work. And we had a babysitter for like a week. And I was like, yeah, mum and dad let me do it all the time. And I'd watch dad drain the pool to clean it. So I knew exactly the tap to turn to pop, like reverse pump it out. I was like, yeah, don't worry about it. And then like, what's your favorite food to cook?
Yeah, I'm gonna say a real big, nice steak and some potatoes.
I reckon can't
beat it.
You can't beat a decent steak. That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah, yeah. Not all the time, but yeah, definitely, you know, once a month.
I got
spoil myself with a big piece of steak. Describe Phillip Island in one word.
One word. The best, I think. I think most of us riders, if you're a real rider, for one, it's left-handed. We all like left-handed tracks. Two, it's like old school, proper positive cambers on all the corners pretty much. And
Super quick.
You can really let the bike flow. So I think, and then with the elevation changes as well, I think it just makes it unreal. It just makes it the ultimate rider's track.
It's nothing like coming over to Lukey.
Exactly. Well, I mean, you wait till you get on some decent power and you can, you use
rip
that.
It over the hill.
Especially on a qualifying lap when you can really let it eat over there. So, so much fun. So.
Couldn't agree more. I got one more, I think. If you could have a coffee with any athlete anytime, who would he or she be?
There's no one in particular, I don't think.
I'll just say
you and I. Yeah, I think that's good enough, isn't
there
it?
There you go.
There's no one in particular.
Change coffee for beer.
Exactly. We'll change the coffee for a nice afternoon beer.
That's it. Couldn't agree more.
G'day YouTube. Be sure to click the notification bell to make sure you don't miss out on any more videos.